I would say.
You should go out there, you know, be like Barb's Cartel. Go put your music out there. He's in jail right now, but he still keeps putting the bangers out there.
Yeah.
Go, like, be bigger than Drake.
Yeah, well, those, you know, that we do, you know, it's like your, you know, it's like your parents, you know, you want to exceed, you know, whatever they accomplish, you know. So when it comes to Drake, Vibes Cartel, you know, man, like Popcorn, you know, those people, we have to pay homage to them, you know what I'm saying? Bound to Kill a Beanie Man, Said Speed, you know, and people even before them, the Barris Hammonds, you know, the I'm a Jack Cure fan too, and Sizzla, I can put them in that mix. You know what I mean? That's where my motivation and, you know, comes from, those guys. You know, so as what you're saying, you know, that's the long-term goal, you know, but we're not in no rush to be bigger than these guys, you know, because we have to still pay homage, you know what I'm saying? And just follow those footsteps on the good things and the right things that they do, and eventually we'll get there over time, you know, but we're not in no rush, you know, but that's the long-term goal.
What's the best advice that someone has gave to you?
The best advice I've gotten is from another music legend of mine. That's out there right now, you know, doing good things. And it's like, he told me, he's like, yo, just work on perfecting the craft, you know? Like, don't be in any rush to get on the cloud trying to chase anything or trying to do a funnier style or anything to get there, you know what I'm saying? Because that's only going to last for a period of time. So it's like just staying in the gym, you know what I'm saying? Getting those shots up, you know what I'm saying? And eventually perfecting it, you know what I mean? So you become legendary, you know what I'm saying? So that's the thing, you know? So that's the best advice I've gotten.
That's really good advice, whoever told you that. If you could dabble into another genre of music, what would it be?
Hip-hop.
Hip-hop?
Yeah. It would definitely be hip-hop. Yeah, because I have a strong hip-hop influence on even my dancehall music.
I've noticed that, like, your one song, it's like, you feel like it's like dance hall, and you feel like I get like Vibes Cartel vibes, and then when you go into hip hop, it's kind of like Drake mixed with The Weeknd.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
it's really good music.
All right.
How did you get started into your career?
I've always been around music. A lot of prominent musicians that came out in reggae and dance hall music, I've been around, you know, since I was a kid. So music's always been there. So as far as my career, taking music serious, it's been on and off, you know. I've started 2005, you know, did a lot of openings, you know, in Toronto for a lot of good artists, you know, Luciano, Sizzla, Beanie Man, Lexus, who else, what's he called? I forgot his name now, he's another good one. But a lot of guys, so that's where my career really started, 2005, 2006, seriously, you know what I'm saying? And because of certain things, you know, in the street, you know, we get sidetracked from it, you know, regular life, you know, survive, because music money is slow, so you have to have